Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. Have you ever had one of those weeks where at the beginning of the week you had a pretty good handle on your personal responsibilities and knew what needed to be done, but by the end of the week your life was in shambles and you could do nothing but lay there, crushed and defeated, naked and exposed with your shortcomings laid bare for all the world to see? Metaphorically speaking, of course. Well, it happened again this week, and what timing. For a week it was, my friends. The tech world is still reeling after being shaken to its foundations with Intel's ongoing anti-reliability Raptor Lake CPU scandal, though help may be arriving sooner than expected. AMD managed to not capitalize on the situation by debuting a power-limited 9700X with underwhelming performance, and it's rumored that Nvidia might be experiencing their own difficulties with upcoming Blackwell GPUs. So, if you're feeling like your performance was less than adequate this week, remember that the struggle bus comes for us all. And since we're all in this together, might as well crack a beer and check out some tech news. Cheers. Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. Intel's CPU instability problems have been solved, and the brand's public standing and reputation have been fully restored thanks to Microcode Update 0x129, which Intel says will address incorrect voltage requests to the processor that are causing elevated operating voltage, per a community blog post Friday. BIOSes with the update should be available now or very soon via motherboard manufacturer support websites. Naturally, we're all just assuming this will work without further testing or scrutiny, and I'm told Steve and Wendell are preparing a lengthy apology video asking for Pat Gelsinger's forgiveness. But hold on a moment. Actually, it looks like Jay, who is known both for his classy taste in eyewear and his minimalist approach to pocket change, has posted some comparison tests to see if Intel's claims that the update won't affect overclocking or performance are true. And Jay's numbers show a lot of similarity in the before and after, with a slight dip in the Geekbench test and a more pronounced one in the TimeSpy Extreme CPU test. Cyberpunk at 1080 also lost about 3% FPS, but perhaps most notable was the reduced voltage spikes evident in his Cinebench stress test, as also evidenced by the drop in package power usage at the same time. These were day one or day zero tests posted right after the microcode patch was made available via an MSI BIOS update, so we'll undoubtedly see more tests in the coming days, but it's hopefully an indication that Intel can correct the problem without significantly impacting performance. No one would blame you for not being cautiously optimistic regarding Intel CPUs, though, given the lingering questions and potential edge cases. Intel says performance isn't impacted and chips won't fail with the update, but only time can tell if that holds true. Intel says warranties will be extended by 2 years for Raptor Lake CPUs, but you don't have to look hard to find reports of consumer difficulties with Intel CPU RMAs, whether that be due to lengthy turnaround times, extensive back and forth to verify purchase details, or outright rejection. And the resale prospect for 13th and 14th gen is already tarnished, since there will be units damaged by high voltage and the earlier problems with 13th gen oxidation on the market, making used purchases a high-stakes crapshoot. The Verge balanced a bit of their PC karma this week by asking OEM system manufacturers about warranty updates, with answers ranging from up to a 5-year warranty extension from good guy boutique builders like Digital Storm, Falcon Northwest, and Main Gear, to no extension at all from the stingy jerks at Acer and Lenovo. And as for how Intel is doing internally, well, they've been spending so much time firing people, which takes a lot of work, that they will not be innovating in 2024. Intel innovation has been pushed to 2025. the event, that is. Although I'm not sure how that reflects on the stuff they are still planning to launch this year. Arrow Lake, which could consume 100 watts less than Raptor Lake, which would be really nice. And even nicer, supposedly, no instability issues, if we're giving Intel credit for stuff they're supposed to do. And maybe even a Battlemage GPU launch still in 2024, which would also be quite a nice distraction. All this was mentioned at an ASUS Intel event in China this week, per a Chinese reporter on Weibo, and what reason would we have to not believe Intel? Speaking of unbelievable news, the tech media disagreed this week somewhat about the new Zen 5 CPUs that AMD just launched, the 6-core 9600X and the 8-core 9700X. The 12 and 16-core launch later this week, but the main critique of the 9700X in particular was how its performance compared to AMD's previous gen 7700X, and how despite its launch price being lower than the 7700X, it does not stack up competitively compared to current market pricing. With the 7700X going for $290 to $300, it's tough to justify paying $60 to $70 more for the 9700X, which isn't always the faster CPU. Its main advantage is power efficiency, and while it's commendable that the 9700X does just as good, if not a better job, while pulling 40 to 60 watts less power, efficiency has always been the least sexy selling point for desktop PC users. It's nice, don't get me wrong, but price and performance will always impact buyers more. AMD seems to have deliberately made the 9700X more akin to the last-gen 7700 non-X with a focus on efficiency, perhaps to leave room in their CPU lineup for the inevitable 9800X3D, which we're hoping will be the all-rounder that we've all been waiting for. And so, Gamers Nexus called the 9700X a wasted opportunity. Hardware Unboxed said Zen 5 sucks for gaming, and User Benchmark said AMD should just give up and not make CPUs anymore. Some were less critical, such as Wendell, who praised the improved memory support and flexibility and maturity of the Ryzen Master software, and Leo from KitGuru said of the 9700X, "I think it's pretty good." And for anyone who thinks, didn't anyone just circumvent those power limits with overclocking, which is fully supported? Yes, check out Der Bauer's video, which includes PBO Max and manual OC results with a very nice increase to Cinebench scores, as well as Scatterbencher, who took the 9700X to 5,860 MHz with a variety of OCing methods. All in all, the 9600X and 9700X have their place. I think they just aren't the 9800X3D or the high core count chips people are more excited about, and they're not good upgrades from Ryzen 7000 either. And they'll definitely benefit from improved sale pricing. And if there are any other outstanding disagreements among the tech media, they will be resolved in next month's cage match. Next up, we proceed with all due haste through tech briefs, starting with Nvidia, who might be delaying their Blackwell GPUs. The AI ones, that is. According to Bloomberg, who heard it from a Microsoft contact, Nvidia's plan to ship Blackwell orders to big customers like Google, Meta, Microsoft, and xAI in Q4 2024 isn't going to happen, and those will be delayed into Q1 2025. The reason might be design flaws, which is both vague and ominous, but for those of us who didn't have 50 to 70 grand saved up to buy one of those Nvidia AI GPUs, what might this mean for gaming PC variants that are thankfully much cheaper? That's not clear yet, but if they're delaying the AI chips, there's a decent chance the gaming variants are affected as well. Nvidia can afford to delay their chips a bit, thanks mostly to their current stranglehold on the AI hardware market. Speaking of potential monopolies, apparently Google has quite the foothold in the internet space, and on Monday, a US district judge ruled that they are, in fact, a monopoly. And even worse, Google has acted as one to maintain its monopoly. I learned this by Googling Google Monopoly, by the way. It's amazing how effective search engines are these days. Now the courts just need to decide what to do about it, with a range of changes or penalties that could be imposed. The next hearing is September 6th, appeals could take up to 5 years, and the impacts of the decision could be far-reaching. What could go wrong? Speaking of AI and data center stuff, I suppose, AMD is continuing their bull run into the space that Intel complacently left wide open to them, now breaking $1 billion in data center revenue, boosted by sales forecasts for their Instinct MI300 AI accelerator GPUs. AMD's EPYC server processors have also steadily increased in popularity since their debut in 2017, so well done, AMD. Now let's just hope Intel doesn't collapse entirely, as we all know how things go for consumers when just one tech company has the dominant position in the market. Poorly. Things go poorly. And finally, we have some electrifying news about power supplies. We saved the exciting stuff for last. Corsair, who sells PSUs, will be switching from the long-standing but oft-critiqued power supply rating standard 80+ to certifications from Cybenetics, which features dual ratings for efficiency and noise generation, as well as multiple testing points across a range of PSU loads versus the 3 points at 2050 and 100% load that 80+ focuses on. Time will tell if other PSU makers follow Corsair's lead and 86, 80+ as well, or if both standards can coexist, like Good Steve and Evil Steve. You never really know which one you're gonna get. But there you have it, guys. Tech news for the weekend. If you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all of the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested, and you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high-quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my YouTube channel is always a good call, too. Thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you next week.